Yo, what's up guys, it's Overlord1469 and welcome back to a new Ninjago video. Season 12, Episode 4, Superstar Rockin' J aired in English recently, so I thought I would make a quick review. As always, I will give my overall thoughts, the pros and cons, and ultimately, how I would rate the episode on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being the worst and 5 being the best. Before we get started though, I wanted to give a huge thanks for the support on my thoughts video for this episode. When it aired in Vietnamese, I made a video stating my overall thoughts and at the time of this recording, it has 1,430 views and 22 likes. I never imagined I would receive that much support on any of my videos, so thank you so much everyone. It means a lot. Also, thanks to you guys subscribing and everything. I'm glad that I have people to be able to deliver content to. Well, enough said. Let's get started with the video. Also, spoiler warning, duh. What a dank meme of an episode. When I thought of Prime Empire, I never imagined we would get something like the League of J. Come on, we all want to be in J's position. He has a fan club that operates around Prime Empire, dresses up like him, and praises him like a king. That scene at the end of the episode when Superstar Rockin' J, quote unquote, is introduced, has got to be my favorite in the episode. Like I said, we all want to be in J's position. The monologue made by the J Avatar before his arrival was just, wow, bravo, bravo. I'm glad that we got to see J's old ninja suits in the new style of animation, especially the ones we got in the classic designs. Hopefully, this means we could get the other ninjas' classic designs animated in the new style. Technically, we already have Cole's and Zane's classic designs in the new style thanks to Season 8. Jay's classic design had another appearance in Season 9. The thing is, we still don't have Kai's, Nia's, or Lloyd's classic designs animated in the new style, so hopefully we will see them in the future. Maybe they could be fit into flashbacks like seen in Season 8 and Season 9. Maybe this is something we will see in the future, maybe not, but this is something I definitely want to become a reality. Cole being excited about video games is something I was happy about. It emphasized more on the close friendship between Jay and Cole. Like I have said in other videos, Unagami's forces are threatening, and I feel scared whenever I see them. Last season, the Pyro Vipers and Blizzard Samurai did not feel as scary, but this villainous faction is being executed really well. Thank you, Ninjago team! Having watched the Prime Empire original shorts, after learning more about him in this episode, Scott has become a really interesting character. I want to see how his last life will impact him later in the season, and if his mechanic skills will help the ninja out. Nia, having done some of that stuff in earlier seasons, can help out maybe? I don't know if she has forgotten those skills though. Hopefully not, I do not like how she lacked those skills in Season 11. Speaking of the Prime Empire original shorts, I'm happy that Season 12 doesn't require you to watch them. I was scared. I once thought that you needed to watch those shorts to be able to understand what is happening in the season, especially that three short arc with Jay and Scott. Thankfully, they just add context to the season and act like bonus content. If you don't want to watch them, you can go to Season 12 directly and completely understand what is going on. I am really happy that so much video game terminology is coming into play this season. The skill tree stuff was interesting. I want to know how the ninja will use it. It was funny when Nia said that it was so easy to get skills in Prime Empire than in the real world, acknowledging it took her months to learn to kick. Also, wow, Ninjago went bold and had one of the J avatars use the word noob. Wow, well played, bravo! It may not be a curse word, but noob is often used to insult new players in a game. I was surprised when I first heard it. What? Did the J avatar just say noob? Wow, just wow. Knowing Ninjago is a show meant for children, noob is not a word a child would use. I think the word is used to make a nod towards the older fans. Like me, for example. I've been watching the show since I was really young. I'm glad. Ninjago is starting to become more aware that it's not just a show meant for children. It's a show that has fans beyond the desired age range. Like me, for example. The show will definitely continue to target young audiences, but hopefully we will get more of these references to nod towards the older fans. I wonder what other video game terminology will show up in Season 12. In addition to all of this, I like the reference of Mr. Cuddly Wump as the League of J's password. If you don't remember, he was a teddy bear J had since he was young. Cole accidentally made some rips with the slow-mo time blade in the episode The Attack from Season 7. I'm glad we got a reference like this and I hope to see more. As for cons, there are only two that I have to name. Don't get me wrong, I am happy that the ninja cannot use their powers or spin jutsu in Prime Empire. They are forced to branch out and use something other than that. It reminds me of when select ninja members did not have their powers in Season 4 and Season 5. The thing though with Kai is that he just had to recover his powers in Season 11. He literally said in the episode, "Can I not go 2 seconds without losing my elemental powers?" This is Ninjago being a self-aware version of Cinema Sins. Hopefully, Kai can go through Season 13 using his powers because otherwise, his loss of powers and possibly that of the other ninja will be extremely repetitive. Here's the second con. Kai wasting his lives was expected based on his personality. I just don't like how he is so selfish and cocky in seasons lately. It's like he has not learned a thing since the beginning of the series. First, it was the Green Ninja thing. Then him wanting to have died in the place of Zane after the ninja defeated the Golden Master. He was at a good point as a character in Season 5, but it has been like all that development was thrown away lately. Hopefully this is made up somewhere down the line in the season because why, Kai? Just why? Overall, despite its flaws, I have to give the episode a 5. What a dank meme of an episode. It has a lot of potential to be my favorite episode in Season 12. I love the League of J. It has got to be my favorite concept this season. I desperately want to know their role in the future of the season. But yeah, that's all I have to say. More Season 12 episodes will air in English next weekend, so stay tuned for more episode reviews. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.
Attention, League of J. League of J. It is time for the arrival of our hero, our inspiration, the reason for our very existence. Superstar Rockin' J himself.
Is this place awesome or what?